our motivation. Today's motivational speaker, Mrs. Suman Kumar, founder, director on Kobe board, has been actively involved in all major decisions of the Kobe board of directors. Mrs. Suman Kumar is the director on the board of Sukasu Cera Colors Private Limited, started in the year 93 with British collaboration to manufacture ceramic colors and import a substitute. Her first unit to manufacture expanded polystyrene products was started in the year 88. She was on the board of ANRICH, a government body to support NRIs. Mrs. Suman has been on the board of Southern Regional Advisory Board of CPE and later elevated to the board of directors of CPE. Currently, Mrs. Kumar is on the board of Bajaj Electronics, a well-known name in electronic goods market. Mrs. Suman is pursuing her hobbies of singing bhajans and other things of interest. An enterprising woman, role model to many, I take privilege of inviting Mrs. Suman Kumar to give her inspirational speech. Madam, over to you, Sumanji.
Thank you, Parvati. Friends, I have been asked to speak on motivation. I do believe that you are attending this webinar, hence motivated already, and are ready to take the challenge of starting an enterprise. At the same time, I need to stress on few points. Firstly, entrepreneurship is no child's play, nor is it any rocket science. It is what you make of it. A financier looks at the person and then the idea behind, nothing else. Why call it entrepreneurship? As the word suggests, it is an enterprise started by an individual. Enterprise is an undertaking, bold or difficult one. It's not an easy task. Readiness to engage in such undertakings with courage and imagination. It is the ability of the person to perform with passion, perseverance, and hard work with commitment. Whether it is our money or others, it has to be well utilized and well protected. If you are successful, the rewards are many, not only the financial freedom that you get, but you are worthy of appreciation, respect, and admiration. You develop ability in decision-making and leading a team. You've become a role model and you are in a position to help others through entrepreneurship. From job seeker, you become a job giver. I would like to first start with the most difficult part of picking up an idea. And it is a very challenging task. A lot of people are very fickle-minded. They'll pick up one project, work halfway, go to the other, and to the other, and to the other, and finally they don't land up anywhere. Of course, like Mr. Dayakar already said, Google is very, very good. It gives you all kinds of information, but we should go to the markets, do a little bit of market survey, look at newspaper ads, also discuss with friends, relatives, and colleagues, neighbors, and go to the market and look for demand-supply gap and also shortages. During COVID lockdown, there were a lot of business ideas which came up. People started giving complex cold-pressed oil, hydroponics for green vegetables, variety of food products, even laddus supplied on our gate. You can pick up ideas from your grandma's recipes also. Some years back, when my maid servant's daughter got married, I gave her a machine and I gave her a training in a stitching tailor's shop. When she got married, she used to earn 2,000 rupees from there. She didn't like it. She worked to a 20,000 loan and did a beauty parlor course. She came back to me and she said she's not getting a job. So I introduced her to a friend of mine who had a parlor. She went there and today she's earning 24,000 per month. She says she will save up money and start her own parlor because that has been her passion. So even if we find that we want to make something, like NABARD had set up a stall at our industrial estate with bags and bags made of plastic ribbon. Not one was sold. We may have the caliber to do something, but if the market doesn't accept it, it is no use. It cannot become a business until it is accepted by the market. Some years back, a lady left her very highly placed corporate job, came to me, and she said she wants to market food products. I was shocked because food products marketing is the most difficult task because they are not standardized. And to reach out, how many people can you sell whatever you make? But initially she said, no, she has to do this. And she said she would sell maida to bakery. I said, that's not the right thing for you to do because they are already getting maida and the margins will be small and it's very easily available. You're not doing any value addition to that. So I sent her to one Mr. Patni who sources all the products imported and national and even supplies to Qmart. So she went to him and I think he engaged her to market his products. But later on she came to me that she was not happy and she was cheated. Ultimately, that gave her another challenge. She said she will overcome this and she will start marketing. And till last year, she was selling most of the products to hotels and her turnover last year was 3 crores. So now before COVID, she decided that she will pass on this business to her driver who has been very faithful to her. And she has started working on sourdough and soon she will set up a bakery with sourdough. So that is something, a corporate job did not satisfy her as much as making sourdough in the kitchen is she's loving it now. Similarly, I will talk about another lady who had very early in COVID, she had started, the pizzas had just started. So she started making mozzarella cheese and yeast. And she used to buy milk and make mozzarella cheese. She was very happy. It was doing very well. But then soon the milk lady said, at this cost. And so she was baffled. She never added any other product. She could have used whey that she takes out. She could have used whey for certain products and she could have added on paneer and other things, milk products. She didn't do all that and she went out of business. So we have to keep innovating. That is very important. I did an ED. Take up the course. It was a 1 month course and the consultants gave us advice on the different kinds of products that could be started. And my husband always felt if there's a shortage of products, that is the time to start the business. So he gave me an idea of thermocol, expanded polystyrene. And it is used in air conditioning and my husband had worked in air conditioning industry. So he said, Suman, there's no industry of this kind in Andhra Pradesh and I think we should take it up. And we finally took it up and made a success out of it. Then when we diversified, he was working for a ceramic industry and realized ceramic colors were not available in India. So we started a ceramic colors unit. So this is how we got into business. And now ceramic colors have also gone into digital printing. We cannot manufacture those. So we have started manufacturing allied products and also marketing allied products. And that is how our business goes. So innovation, expansion, and also now again, you can talk to raw material suppliers. You can talk to, you can look for a better price. You could be stockist for them. You could be, you can do so many other things to keep your business going. So ladies, don't waste time. Get down to the job. Take advantage of the schemes of the government. Start looking for project ideas. Once you decide the idea, stick to it unless you find it worthless. Don't, the moment you think it's worthless, leave it. But don't keep leaving and picking. Now, if you have finalized your project ideas, say Mr. Dayakar Reddy's notebook you want to manufacture. You have to look at, is it a trading activity or is it a manufacturing? It is always better you buy books, notebooks and sell. Do market seeding. Find your market and then go back to manufacturing. If you spend a crore and then you don't have a market, you will at least know who are your competitors that way and whether you can make a niche in the market. All that will give you that little benefit if you have do market seeding. So you can start with a trading activity. Then you can look at a manufacturing activity. Or is it a processing industry? Maybe you're just printing and selling. Or even if is it whether it's a rural activity, whether it's something to do with agriculture or food processing or something like that. The requirements of space, equipment, manpower will be different for each activity. I know a lady who wanted to start a reeling industry in AP. And there was no technician to do reeling. They didn't have fingers to reel the thread. And so he moved to Bangalore and got it done. So you have to look at whether the manpower is available in the place you want to set up the industry. So it is the the manpower, then technology. You can buy the technology, you can learn the technology, or you can hire somebody with the technology. I would suggest don't hire someone with the technology, because this business world is very, very dirty. They pinch your people from the lab, they pinch your people from the factory. It has happened with us and it can happen to anybody. So don't ever go with it, depend on one person. I would best advise we bought technology of ceramic colors from a British company. And so we know we can innovate. If we have the technology, we can innovate, we can expand, we can do everything. But if we depend on somebody, we have to depend on his moods, his interests. It is always better to acquire tech and not depend on an individual. Once you know the place, requirement of land and building and machinery, also technology, you need to work out your finances. Bank schemes keep changing. Find out the right scheme applicable to you. If it is a rural industry, you will go to NABARD. If it is otherwise MSME, if required, find out a good consultant to help you. At the same time, keep working on acquiring skills and knowledge of your project. Try and talk to bankers and prospective clients. It may be a good idea to create a company which can be of proprietorship or a partnership with another person, and start putting expenses on the company account. Later, when you go to bank for loan, they will ask you to bring 33% of the total requirement of the project. The money spent can be part of your contribution. Start small. Some of the big names started in a garage. If you are a first generation entrepreneur, you may first try with your market and then expand. My experience says that you get established in 5 years and is ready for expansion in 10 years. I find this happening in schools also. Take care of your statutory requirements like pollution control. They have green, orange, and red categories. And there are industrial estates developed exclusively for each. We are now in Enrich Industrial Estate in Miapur, Bolaram. This was set up for NRIs. Today, there is a township around it. And industries like Reddy Labs are feeling that he may be asked to move one day. And so will we be. Do we still want to be in business with the shifting 5 acres of land into some other industrial estate? Factory rules of manpower. We have to follow manpower because they're very strict. You cannot employ children below 14 years. Land rules of usage and water disposal. Second thing, water, they are very strict with water consumption. And hence we have to give them the right figures so that you are able to be in line with them. Electricity consumption, you have to decide whether it's LT or HT. Taxes, interstate and in-state. Finally, financial discipline. The managing director is responsible for all this and has to be totally involved. We believe, khud mare swag nahi milta, khud khaye swad nahi milta. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you very much. It's truly inspirational. And thank you very much, ma'am. Now, moving on to the next session, bankers speak.